hell of a workout. But just to remind you that this weekend, 17th and 18th, I have a CCNA bootcamp, meat and potatoes. But I'm just not, it's not about that. I'm leaving you with episode 4. See you there. Hey, welcome back everybody. Episode 4, finally, right? We're gonna start doing ACLs, right? We're gonna secure our network using access list. Now, there's a million ways you can secure your network, but for your CCNA, whether it's the new one or this one, the CCNA 200-125, you're gonna need to know how to configure access list. So let's take a look. Now, as it says right there, an ACL is read from top to bottom, right? From the most specific to the most general, meaning you're gonna say, hey, I'm blocking this particular hose, allow everybody else. So it goes line by line by line by line by line. Now, when you create an ACL, whether it be an extended or a standard or even a named access list, which we'll get into that as well, if you have a deny statement anywhere in there, you need to make sure that you're going to go ahead and have a permit any or permit any or IP any in there. Okay, if not, everything is going to be denied because there's that implicit deny at the end of every access list that says deny everything. So you got to be careful when taking the test. Okay, when you're doing these, make sure that if there's a deny statement, all right, that you have a permit at the end. It doesn't make sense to put, if you say permit host 1.20 say 1.1 and then say permit any, because then that defeats the purpose. But if it says deny host, whatever, okay, then you need to put the deny, the permit any at the end so everybody else can do what they need to do. Just keep that in mind. And you see the rule here is you're only allowed one access list per interface, per protocol, per direction. All right, so we're gonna do a little something let's take a look at it. A standard access list, okay, you can only place it nearest the destination, because since you can only say access list one, deny 192.168.1.1, right, that would be the syntax, and then permit any. But what are you denying? What protocol, what port number? You don't know. It's a very general statement. So you got to take it all the way to the destination so they can go ahead and just basically don't have access to that area. Okay, so you got to be very careful when using a standard access list. But it's limited, like it says there. But what we're going to do is also, we're going to create one like that, and we're going to create one that will permit or deny your telnet lines. And it all depends on how you apply it or where you apply it, okay? That's the whole thing. Because normally accesses are applied in an interface. We're going to go ahead and apply it in a particular line. You'll see, okay? Extended access list. Well, let's finish off with the standard. Closest to a destination, can we use source addresses? That's it, that's all you can use. And there's the range. Is there an extended range? Yes, there's an extended range, but you're not gonna be, they're gonna ask you about the extended range. No, your normal range, which is 1 through 99, okay? Then you have your extended, and keep in mind, these are numbered access lists. Closest to the source, okay? Because why? You can use a protocol. You can use a source and destination addresses, and you can use port numbers. So now you're being very specific as to what you're going to permit or deny. So you can place it nearest a source. But Cisco is making you think outside the box. Okay? It's making you think outside the box. So be ready for that. All right? Just because it's, the book says is nearest the source, because you're very specific when you want to deny or permit something, that way it doesn't take up processing power or bandwidth or anything like that. But okay, if you put it nearest the source, there may be another entry point where somebody can bypass the ACL. So really, you place an ACL where it's needed. So everyone can go ahead and they have to go through that ACL in order for things to take effect. Okay? So the range is 100 to 199, and you can see that it's very flexible because it can use protocols, source and destination addresses, and port numbers. Okay? Now, remarks is something that's new and also named, actually, because we named access list. It's the same thing. It's either going to be standard or extended, but instead of putting a number, you're going to put a name. So when you're applying it, you're not going to put it, when you put it in the interface, that's where you apply access list. You're not going to say IP access group and then a number. You're going to actually say IP access group and then the name. And then, of course, the direction, whether it's in or out. Now, people get confused between in or out. And as we do the lab, I'll show you, it's based on the router. Are you going in the router or are you coming out of the router? But remember the rule, one access list per protocol, per interface, per direction. Okay, so one going in, one coming out. And I'll show you how to look at all this. And then the newest one is remarks. And this is just to give it more of a description. Hey, this is what this access list is doing, okay? This access list is for the executive directors not to mess around where they don't need to be going. Whatever you want to put on there, okay? But at least somebody looks at that, they look at the remarks and they say, oh, okay, this is what this access list is actually doing in a little bit more detail than just block sales, block accounting. Yeah, things of that nature. So a little bit more descriptive, all right? So let's get ready and let's get inside the lab. See you there. All right, so here we are in the lab, in our one big lab here. All right, so what we're gonna do is, we're gonna do a standard access list. Remember the range is 1 through 99. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna use this host right here, okay, and that is host 20.1, where you can see it's getting an IP address from the DHCP server. So 20.1, we're gonna deny that particular PC access to this area because we really can't be specific. We have to be very general. So that means we need to put it nearest the destination. All right, so let's see first that campaign. And I've tried before because I always check to see if I have connectivity. First thing you wanna do when you get into your labs, especially in a simulator or emulator, and you're having an ongoing lab, you wanna make sure that what you've done already is still there and it's still working, okay? So, not terminal. Let's go to command prompt. You can see I tried already, and we do have connectivity. All right, so we're gonna go inside this router right here, router 3, and let's open this up. Start from right here, and we're gonna go to, I'll just go a little here. All right, let's go to CLI, I'm going to enable, config T. All right, so our goal is to create a standard access list that's going to deny that 192.168.20.1 from gaining access to that server. And you can see I'm at the router that's closest to that server, which is that destination right there. Okay, I'm going to say access, I'm going to tap access list 1, that's the range. If you don't know, you forgot, you can question mark it. And there's the extended, which they're not going to ask you about, but 1, right? What am I trying to do? I'm trying to deny who. I can do host 192.168.1.1. That's it. Or I can say, use a wildcard mask and say 192.168.1.1. It's 20.1. And I can say 0000. It's the same thing because zeros mean match exactly. All right, so you're saying match exactly each octet and this is the guy we're denying, all right? But I'm lazy, I don't wanna type. So I'm just gonna say host 192.168, oops, forgot the decimal, 168.20.1. So I'm denying, so I gotta end it with a permit statement. So I'm gonna say access list, not kissed, 1 permit. Oh, permit any, how about that, lads? Permit any, okay. So we permit any, so Now, you can create an access list all day, every day, and if you don't apply it, it's not gonna do anything. And let's look at it. How do we look at it? Show access list. That's the only access list that exists on this particular router. It says there, standard IP access list one. And then the first line says, hey, I'm denying this particular host and I'm permitting everybody else. Okay, is it working? Well, let's see. Of course not, okay? Because you have not applied it. Now, this is where the decision you need to make, right? If you go by the book, you say, okay, nearest source is this interface down here, right? The G00 that's going out this way, okay? So you need to apply it to this interface as per the book. If you apply it here, I mean, if you're gonna apply it here, you're denying that access list, you're not even closer. Put it here and you deny going into the router. But if you deny it here, you're gonna deny him going anywhere else. Because since you're not specific, you're just denying this particular host. You understand? If you put it here going in the router, that's the direction you gotta tell it. Hey, I'm coming in the router. But when it sees it, it says, well, wait a minute, you're 192.168.20.1, you're denied. So I can't go anywhere else. So you have to put it nearest the source. So in this situation, in this particular type of topology, and that is what you need to pay attention to, the type of topology you have. So let's go back in here and we're gonna do it. Let's just make sure that that is show IP in brief. I'm gonna put in the correct interface, show IP in brief. All right, and it is the G00, here it is right here. Okay, G00. You want to go config T, int G0/0, enter. Okay, and we're going to say IP. This is how you apply an access list, okay, to an interface. IP access group. What group? One. Which direction? Well, it's already in the router. It's trying to get out of the router. So we're gonna say out, WR. Now, how do you look at that? Well, you know where you applied it. So show IP interface G0/0. And then you should see there an outgoing access list one. All right, so if I take that out, nothing's happening. But now I applied it. Now, 192.168.20.1 should not be able to ping or anything. It's not allowed to get here, period. Right? It's not allowed to leave that interface. That's what should happen. That's it. Yeah, so the packet tracer always say should. And destination unreachable. Now, did that mess anybody else up because I did that? Let's check. Ping 1.9.1.1.1.1. No, it didn't, because the second line of the access list says permit anybody else, so anybody else can get to it, but not this computer. But not only is it blocking ping, it's blocking everything. You're just being denied. You can't leave this interface. So whatever computers or printers or whatever you put on this side of the network, you're not allowed to get there. You're not allowed. That's the problem with standard access lists, that they're very limited. They're very limited. Now, we do use standard access lists in NAT, okay? But they're used for a different purpose. They're used for a different purpose. All right, but let's do the other type of access list. I said that I was gonna use a standard access list to deny or permit telnet. Elias, you said you can't do that. You're right, I can't tell it, hey, use a protocol, use a port number, I can't do that. But it's where I apply it. All right, so what we're gonna do is, we're gonna allow this particular individual access to this router, because the only one we can tell into, right? We can only tell us into a router. So, to telnet into router one. He is the only one that we're going to allow to telnet into router one, period. nobody else. Okay, so let's make sure. Gotta scratch your throat. Excuse me. Been a little bit under the weather lately. All right, so I'm gonna enter. Do enable. Conf team. Let's do a couple passwords there. Enable password Cisco. Then let's do align. 0 password Cisco and login, and then let's do the telnet lines, all telnet lines, line BTY 015 password Cisco login. Please make sure, okay, that in your test, if there's something like this, that, you know, if it's uppercase L, you know, using proper English, proper grammar. All right, now that it's all lowercase or uppercase, be very careful because you may get frustrated. I can't log in. See what the spelling is. All right, do WR. You cannot do WR. All right, so let's see if indeed I can telnet from here inside this router before we create anything. First, let's check that. All right, so we're gonna do telnet. My gateway. 192.168.10.254 Cisco. All right, enable Cisco, and I'm in the router. Awesome. Show start. I can see all my stuff in there, right? Cool. So I'm gonna exit out of here. So now you can see I can telnet in there. All right, can this guy telnet in there? Let's see. Telnet 192.168.20.254. Hey, he can telnet too. Cisco, and then enable, and then Cisco, and I'm in. All right. So you can see that everyone can telnet, and if I do it to the server, he'll be able to telnet as well. All right. But now that's not what we want. What we want is to only allow 192, the VLAN 10, that specific host PC0 to telnet into that router only. Everybody else is denied. No problem. Using a standard access list. What are you talking about? Can you use protocol? Crazy. No. All right, so we're gonna do config team. And then we're gonna do access list. Let's make this 10, whatever, it's still in the range. Permit host 192.168. Well, first of all, let me look at his IP address. It should be 10.1. I just want to make sure. Yeah, 10.1. Okay. So we're going to permit host 192.168.10.1. And that's all I'm going to do. I'm going to let the implicit deny everybody else. Right? Because that's that invisible deny that exists at the end. All right. It doesn't make sense if I put access list 10 permit any, then wait a minute, you're permitting this host and then you're permitting everybody else. So why even create an access list? Just leave it alone. So I'm only allowing that one, but it's still not telling me, well, permit them to what? Okay, so what we do, we go to line BTY 0 space 15, the telnet lines, and go access, okay, class 10, and it's trying to get what? It's trying to get into the router. It's trying to telnet into the router. So that's the direction. And put my hand. Cool. Done. And let me do a copy run start also. Sometimes this gets crazy. Make sure it's done. Let's take a look. Here's your access list, 10. You can do show access list to see that. But what I want to see is this right here. Okay. So that's there. All right, cool. Let's see if we can telnet again. That's just up arrow, right? That should not have happened. Ah, but do you know why that happened? Well, let's follow through. So we're gonna do a barrel. Hey, it's letting me in. Why is that happening? I'm under a sub interface, but I'm doing it to the telnet lines. So that should not happen because it's access class 10N. But it should not allow 10.1. Actually, there's 10 permit rules. Oh no, I'm permitting this guy. Yeah, he can. Crazy. Okay, so he can permit. See, I thought I was able to deny him. Of course he can't get in. All right, so let's just exit right here. So he can get in. Good, because that's the guy I'm permitting. Hello. Yeah, this comes with old age. Gray matters leaving. So he should not be able to get in. there we go. So he's not able to get into any to telnet. He can ping it. Ping 192.168.20.254, which is his gateway. He can ping it, but he cannot telnet into it. We can go through it, ping 101.101. Oh, what did I do? Hold on. I'm gonna try paying. Yeah, no. There is no 10.1.1.10. Okay. Oh no, that's my is it ping 192.168.20.254. We're good there. Let's pick something on the other side, which is 10.5. Ping 10.1.1.5. We're good. Okay, so we can get past that point. We should be able to get to all the way. Oh, that's right. I'm blocking him. This guy has an access to this. Let's block him to get to that side. Hello. All right. So you can see you can still ping through it, but you can't telnet into the router. So that implicit deny, and if you look at it, you'll see matches. Show access list. All right. You see it made 4 matches. Okay. So you could use a standard access list to block telnet. Since you are limited on the amount of access lists they can put on an interface, okay? Why bother putting an extended access list to block telnet when you can just use a standard access list and apply it to the lines? And it really doesn't matter in which direction. Well, obviously you want to permit going in, but hey, he can still, what if I, if he's the only one, is he going to be allowed to telnet into the router? Telnet. No. Okay? Because it's applied to the telnet line. So it doesn't matter if you're coming in through here, through here, through here, through here, through here. You have 200 ports on here. It doesn't really matter because you applied it to a line. So when they try to use that particular port, they're gonna be blocked, okay? Again, applying a standard access list to an interface, you're limited to just you or a network can't get to this area. But if you wanna use it for telnet, you can just create, hey, permit the network, permit these hosts, deny everybody else. Use the implicit deny to deny everybody else. So there's two types of that standard access that you can create. It all depends on where you apply it. To a line, using the access class command, or if on an interface, IP access group. Remember, you need to think, am I going in the router or am I going out of the router, leaving the router? That's how you know which direction to put it in. All right, now we're gonna do an extended access list. Extended. So what's going to happen is, since we haven't messed around with the server, we're going to say, okay, the server is the only guy that can have web access to this server right over here. Okay? He's the only one that can have web access. Everybody else and their mother can't use web access to that particular server over here. That 101.101.101. They can go ahead and ping it. They can do other things, right? But they cannot have web access. According to the book, you do it nearest the source. Well, the source would be here. Okay? And in this scenario, okay, everybody has to go through here anyway, so you can apply it here if you wanted to. But what if there's people over here? And what if there's people over here? They won't go through the access list. So you gotta put it at the funnel. Think outside the box. You gotta put it in the funnel, because if there's people here and there's people here, if you apply the access list, the extended one, going in on this router, well, whoever's here and here is gonna be able to go in without a problem. So you gotta make sure that no one else, because that's what it says, no one else can have access to that server right there through port 80. So we're gonna create it where? Right here, again. Again, now is an extended access list. All right, that's 30, that should be 30, that one, right? Yeah, okay, in here, all right. So 30.1. Again, numbered access list. Access, config, T, IP, no. Access list as an extended 100. Okay. Permit the TCP protocol to host 192.168.30.1 source address to this destination address using port that equals, that's what the EQ stands for, equals port 80. That's what the line says. Left to right, that's the way it needs to be. The number of the access list, in this case is an extended, so it's gonna be 100.199. The action, permit or deny. What protocol, in this case TCP. Source address, which is this right here, or the entire network, you want to put zero and then a wildcard mask, to the destination address, which port? Port 80. That's the correct syntax. Now, anybody else is denied. Nobody else is allowed to use port 80 to get to the server. Okay, as long as I access, hyphen list, 100, deny the TCP protocol to any source to this particular destination, which is host, it is kind of hot, 1.1.1.1, that equals 480. All right, so that line again, we have the number of the access list, the action that we're using, the protocol, source, anybody, to the destination, and then the port number. And then the last line is access, list 100, permit IP, the rest of the IP suite. IP, any source, any destination. Oh, I'll put an equal sign. Whoa. And let's take a look at it, since I did that little mistake there. Show access list 100. So we're saying it's an extended, right? Because it's using 100. It says permit, boom, 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 host 31 to 101 to that port. Yes, it changes it automatically, the same thing. Then you're denying TCP to any source to that destination. And then you're permitting IP any. All right, cool. So we're good to go. We're fine. But remember, we already have an access list outgoing on there, right? Show IP interface G0/0. Okay. And when we look at it, we have an outgoing access list 1. We need to get rid of that because we need to apply a 100. Remember, one protocol per interface per direction. So what we're going to do is we're going to say FFT interface G0/0 no IP access group 1 out. Copy that. And always verify that what you typed actually worked. Control Z. Right, show. Alright, and you see there is nothing now. No outgoing access list is set. Awesome. So we're gonna apply now the extended access list. So we're gonna complete T interface G0/0. IP access group. What group? Well, we said it was 100, correct? That's what we did. 100. Okay. So IP access group 100. Which direction? Out. Because I'm trying to leave the router. Okay. Enter. DWR. Now if we were to do show access list. Show access list. So we have two. We have a standard and an extended. The extended right now is the one that's applied. So that's the one that's working. All right. And you can see it says, okay, I'm permitting this guy 31 to this guy 111. Then everybody else is denied to that guy using that port, and then I'm permitting anything else. All right. So, well, let's test this out. Let's see if he can actually ping. Remember, we took that out. So can he ping? Hey, look, he can ping again. Before he couldn't, okay? All right, so let's see. Port 80, right? So we go to the browser, we type 101.101. And not real internet. Yes, it's not the real internet, okay? So we can get there. Let's see this guy. He should not be able to get there. So I was able to ping. Should get a request on mouse. Takes a little bit. It is a very big network. Alright. You get a request timeout. And then this one up here. And he should be able to still ping. Alright, he can ping. But he cannot. Alright, you can see. Your request amount. So your access list is actually working. So extended access lists are more flexible, but again, you gotta think, where am I gonna place it? I can place it right here. That's what the book says, right here, going into a router. But then anybody here, right, will be affected by it because they gotta go through that port. But if you have people here, and if you have people here, they don't have to go through that router. They just gotta go straight this way, so they won't be affected. And the statement says, everybody else. So you gotta do it at the funnel. Now, one thing I did not show was remarks. And I'll show it now, when we do the named access list. Now we'll just do just some bogus named access list, so you can see. It's the same thing. It's either gonna be an extended or a standard. The only difference is how you begin to write the access list. Come on. All right. So up to now, we've been doing what? Access list, blah, 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 right? Access list 100, permit, and all that. So now, oh no. If I send you a lab, okay, or anything like that, and you see a lab, what's the password? Just in the packet tracer, just go here, go into an interface, come back to the CLI, you get to, all right? Sometimes I don't remember myself. All right, so when we're configuring a named access list, we start with IP. IP access list. Say, well, what do you want to do? An extended or a standard? Let's just do a standard. Standard, okay. All right, and this is what's funny. You want to give it a number? Do you want to give it a name? Well, no, I'm going to give it a name. Okay? I'm just going to call it BS. Big old capital letter. BS. And now you're in standard name access list mode. All right? So what do you want to do? I want to deny. Well, what do you want to deny? I want to deny a host. 3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3.3. penny. Okay, there's your named access list. But wait a minute. Look what we got here. And it's the same in the numbered access list or the named access list. You can put a remark. You can say, okay, remark. This access list, or this ACL, let's make it short, is just an example on how to create an ACL, a named ACL. Okay, that's what the remark is. It's just more descriptive. So now that we know that this is a BS access list, okay, because that's not even there, and then that IP address, and then we know we did a standard access list, and we give it that name, we're denying it, permitting everything else, and then now we have an actual description that tells us in detail, what is this access list doing? Doubt that they even get that question on the test. But hey, now you know. And then you would apply it, obviously. Let's exit out of here. And this router 0. Oh, so it's down here. So we'll apply it going out to G02, right? Just to show you how to apply it. So let's do show IP in brief. Yeah, G02. Okay, I'm gonna go int G0/2. How do I apply a named access list? IP access group. Now it's not a number, it's a name. BS out. That's it. It's the same thing. And instead of putting a number here, I put the actual name of it. That's all there's to it. But access lists are essential part of your security when it comes to your network. Do take it seriously, obviously. As far as your certification is concerned, these are pretty much it, what they're gonna be asking you in those rules that I put in the beginning. You know, one access list per protocol, per interface, per direction. You know, the most specific on the top, the most general at the bottom. And then you have, it's read from top to bottom until it makes a match, you know, things of that nature. But, and you have that implicit deny at the end, okay? But think outside the box. Just because the book says that a standard is nearest the source and an extended is nearest destination, careful, okay? And clues to that is just simply, I want you to create an access list that's gonna block port 80, or block port 22, or if they're giving you a specific port and a specific destination, you know it's gonna have to be an extended access list. Because with standard access lists, you can only use what? Source addresses. But you can use it for telnet, but you need to apply it to the telnet lines using the access class command. And remember, you gotta ask yourself the question, is it coming into the router or is it leaving the router? So you can then say, okay, it's going in or out. That's how you can tell the direction that you're gonna apply it to, all right? But that's it, simple as that. Watch the video over and over and over again so you know what's going on. I'll see you in the next one.